What we are about to witness is my good friend Dom showing us how it's done in this event. Dom is an infantry main, and this event in particular is his specialty. So what you're about to see worked for him many times, and throughout the video I will post pictures, and I suggest you stop the video when you see them to read what the pictures are saying and to screenshot them so you can use it in a future time. The first thing I want you to pay attention to is his city placement. You want to have your city somewhere deep in your alliance territory or somewhere where there is terrain blocking, and this is because you want the Lohars to spawn inside your alliance territory so you can have the most buffs possible. What you currently see on the screen is one of the two methods that you need to use in order to place well in this event. This is the slower method, where you use a support march like Trajan with Joan in order to load up your main march with rage. So what you need to do is attack a barbarian with around to 40k to max 60 or 70k T1s. You use T1s in order because it's cheaper and it doesn't do as much damage. You want to keep the barbarian alive. This is where the magic happens. You need to count the skill cycles. Once you reach 10 skill cycles, that means your main march is filled with rage and you may proceed to attack the Lohar. As you will see now, the march is fully filled with rage and the skills pop off immediately. That way it saves you the time to build up your own rage, and it just saves you troops. The Guan march is serving as a blockade, so the Lohar does not spawn outside the alliance territory, and that is also a neat trick to use because you want, as I've said, you want to keep the Lohar in the alliance territory at all times. Moving on to the second method, this is the longer route, and you want to keep using the Trajan march, but also you want to attack another barbarian with another support march such as Constantine and Mulan. This is simply for extra stats and extra protection that this march provides. With the methods now known, you just have to repeat this process before each Lohar and all the way up to the very end. You may have noticed Dom is using an epic city skin, 5% infantry health. This is your best bet, especially if you're using infantry, because the legendary infantry skins are really hard to obtain. So this one gets the job done. Dom is using a 10% defense token, a 25% expansion, a 7% defense rune, and he's not using any titles, which you may find interesting, but to him it says he's just getting unnecessary attention and it could lead to mistake, so he'd rather not have it. With all that said, this may be an infantry showcase video, but these steps are universal no matter which troop type you're going for. If you're going cavalry, you use the cavalry skin, the best one you got. The best are health, defense, and attack. You want to have the best runes as possible. Also, what I didn't mention is you may try to align yourself with the alliance skills, such as counter-offensive and books and battles, for the extra troop attack or defense. Also, check your commander tab. You want to get those little bit of extra stats where you can. And of course, use War Frenzy, scout something, a flag, a farm, something, and keep it going. If you have any questions about this event or any events in the game, commander choices, commander equipment, commander advice, Then I highly suggest you join our Discord, where you can contact myself, Dom, and many others who can help you out. We'll watch the rest of the video, and I will see you in the next one.